kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both teams have sent their special teams out of the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. Lewis takes it at the 16, gets to about the 37-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it.
Before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
Second down and 11. Ball on the 36. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Makes it out to about the 43.
That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. He has some room.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? You better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
It's second and 11. Ball on the 35-yard line.
And they got it.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five wide set. Got it. And he goes down quickly. The defense might be licking their chops right now, Herbie. We've got a change at the quarterback position. We know the kid is talented, but you got to know the defense is going to come after him. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. The kick is up, and it's good. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Morton takes it at the 12. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Fleming's a guy that knows that he's going to have to carry his load today, as well as some of his teammates out there, because this is a tough spot. He's been there before, but not everybody has been.
I think patience will be the big word for him today. You know, as a talented wide receiver, you're playing on the road. You want the ball in your hand. You want a chance to make a difference in this game. And if they start off a little bit slow, he's got to be patient and let the game come to him and be a tremendous leader and eventually allow this offense to execute and be able to win this game in a tough environment.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 28. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up third and four.
tackled immediately after the catch. Fourth down upcoming as they go three and out.
Very nicely done here by the defense. They did a good job of keeping them in check on their side of the field.
Rust is waiting for the snap. Oh, excellent punt. It's a fumble. It's picked up. And they finally bring him down at the 20. And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down. They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
Slings it, and he shoved out of bounds around the 44-yard line.
A part of any quarterback's arsenal should be the ability to sell the run with a good fake. He does a really good job here on the fake, and then they pick up some nice yards.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. Exactly what this defense was looking for.
Yeah, that fumble gives these guys some added life. Now let's see if they can capitalize off of it.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Play action here. He's going to scramble.
Well, they didn't pick up the first down, but he saw that no one was open, so he made the right decision to tuck it and run.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Stop at about the 49. Short game by the running back, and that's a first down.
You like how the offense is playing intelligent, controlled football here, using the safe run to get the first.
And down he goes at about the 47-yard line. Second and 8. Ball on the 47-yard line. Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen. 5-yard loss on the play.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
They need to get it down to the 39. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. He goes out of bounds at the 44-yard line. Credit those two defenses in that first quarter, or blame the offenses for a lack of production. 3-0, Eagles. And we welcome you back to the action here, and we have got a tight one going on in quarter number 2. He's going to try to coffin corner this one. And he's got to be happy with that punt, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, that was nice. So now they're looking at a long way to go to even think about a score.
This offense lost the ball by way of a fumble the last time they had it.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
inside handoff. And he hits him hard at the 25-yard line. And the delayed handoff works for a big gain.
Got to be happy with the effort there by your tailback.
First and 10. Ball on their own 25. And he's taken down at the 24. 1 yard loss for the halfback. Under pressure. He's pushed out of bounds at the 27. That's a 3-yard pickup.
It's a nice play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
Crosses to the running back, and he pulls in another one. That pass play went for nearly enough to keep moving, but they're stopped just short. Boy, that's tough.
That is always a tough pill to swallow. Having to leave the field, knowing how close you came to converting on third down. You got to get those.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt.
There just wasn't anywhere for him to go. Sure, he didn't go backwards, but this return could have been a lot worse.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Some room. Gains his way to the 39-yard line.
Anytime this guy carries the ball and gets a little space, we could be talking about six.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 39. He makes it out to about the 41-yard line. A couple of yards there by the tailback on the counter.
That makes it second and 8.
Double tight. Double tight. Four down. Four down. Mike four. Mike four. Set.
Got the corner. He's at midfield. Knocked out of bounds around the 37-yard line. From the 37-yard line, it's first down.
Three down, three down. Mike four.
Play fake, looking to run. Slides down to the ground.
Slides on the play. Call it a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
Two times, two times. Four down, four down. Mike four, Mike four.
Set. Oklahoma.
And he has it on the corner. Inside the 10. He scores. What a play. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So that's a 5-play, 77-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
And the big plays that they had running the football were the keys to that drive.
The score now, 7-3. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He makes it to the 25-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. West fakes the handoff. Has all day to throw. Brought down around the 48-yard line. First First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 48. Tackle at the 49-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back. The Eagles taking their first time out of the half. Rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He's going to try and scramble. They'll make the sack.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
The Longhorns will use their first time out of the half. Thorne awaits the snap. It's away, and it's a booming punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. One of the nation's top talents really struggling in this one today. Fleming's big playability was supposed to be on display, and yet he's trying to find any kind of rhythm. And we've seen the team rally around, though, and they got the lead here.
Yeah, and Brad, this defense has done just a great job of being able to take him out of this game today. They've been able to just limit his touches. And yet, for some reason, they still find themselves trailing in this game. I think it's a good example of how one player can alter a defensive game plan and really puts this defense in a position where they're going to have to make some adjustments here and try to put more pressure on this team and get the ball back to their own offense.
It's second and eight. Ball on the 22-yard line. Caught with room to work. They'll bring him down at the 32. Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Now he tries to buy some time. He's taken down right around the 42-yard line. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. So that'll make it fourth down.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
Lewis, back to return it. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Well, it's always fun to be part of a defensive battle, and that's certainly what we have right now.
Yeah, give credit to both of these defenses. I mean, they're playing with a lot of energy, and I think they're doing a nice job up front at the line of scrimmage. And at this point, they're not giving either of these offenses a chance to make a play.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 12-yard line. Steps out of bounds at the 15.
Everyday speed you're talking about with this guy. This is a unique burst combined with a really impressive field vision.
From their own 28-yard line, first down. Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield. A great first half comes to a close. The Longhorns lead it by four.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. One thing has been apparent in this first half that we just saw. Both defensive coordinators a step ahead of their counterparts on offense. They've had the answer for every formation, every shift, every movement, every motion that they've tried to come up with. So, to try to break free and get something moving on offense, might it be time to show a little trickeration?
A little trickeration never hurt nobody. I mean, it's something that if you keep doing what you've been doing, you're going to keep getting what you've been getting. And you got to find a way to do something a little bit different because it wasn't working. Let's find some new plays in that book. Let's run a little bit of option. Let's run some reverse. Let's run some double passes. How about we bring a blitz with everybody? Just don't even cover anybody. Just bring everybody. Bring the house. You know, try to do something a little bit out of the ordinary. Try to get a spark going for your ball club.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk ready to roll.
Very close game now as we start the second half. Morton takes it at the 14. And he's taken down at the 32-yard line. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Tackle made around the 45-yard line.
Even if you're pulling for the other team, you've got to just admire this guy's speed. He is special.
From their own 45-yard line. First down. Fumble, loose ball. And they fall on the loose ball. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. So the sack makes this a second and long. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. He's knocked out of bounds at the 33. Sack for a loss. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Rust is waiting for the snap. He makes it to the 38-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. He's under pressure. He's at midfield. And he's tackled around the 43-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it second and 4.
The Longhorns lost a player earlier, and Herbie, this is a big blow to this team. Doesn't look like he's going to play any more football today. He's level at the 27-yard line. From the 27-yard line, it's first down. And down he goes, around the 26-yard line.
a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted. This is just an example of a safety reading the eyes of the quarterback and being able to get a good jump on the football to knock that away from the receiver.
So it's fourth down. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. The kick is up, and he nails the long field goal. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's out to the 30. They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one. The Longhorns have certainly had their opportunities to put this thing away. I don't think they can say they haven't, but they haven't been able to do it.
Well, it's just sloppy execution on offense. You know, whether they're turning the ball over or they're being forced to punt, this is just not an offense right now in rhythm. They've blown their opportunities, and now they've got to hold on and hope that they can get out of here with a win.
Gets out to about the 31.
The defense needs to be careful. The safety might have made that play, but if he keeps coming up on the run, he'll be spaced downfield for the pass.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. Gets it out quickly, and he's shoved out of bounds around the 38-yard line. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
False start. Offense.
It'll be third down again after that penalty.
Yeah, now they have more yards to pick up for the first down.
Here's third and eight. Ball on the 33.
Aiden's getting the ball here. Aiden's getting the ball. Cover. Here we go, Omaha. Omaha.
He's tackled at the 33-yard line. Nice defensive stand there.
And it's a good play calling defensively. They always had someone in the right spot to make a play and force the three and out.
Lewis is back to receive. Booming kick.
This offense is just going to be kicking themselves. They're moving the ball very well. In fact, they're getting into their opponent's territory. The only problem is they're not finishing off the drives with touchdowns. They're having to settle for field goals. That could eventually catch up to them.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's to the 40, and he hits him hard at the 41-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 41. And they make the stop at around the 48-yard line. The corner. He takes it right side for a good gain. About 5 yards in the quarterback keeper.
That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Play action. Deep pass to the end zone.
Hey, that's a heads up play there by the defender. Get those hands up, and something good may just happen.
That'll bring up third and four.
Setting up play action. Once and all, going deep. And he's taken down around the 6-yard line. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and goal. And he is drilled at the 11-yard line.
You're not going to see this very often from this running back. He just got gobbled up pretty deep in the backfield.
Both offenses still trying to find a way to open things up. The end of three quarters. 7-6, Longhorn. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action.
Man left, man left. Four down. Hey, number eight's coming. Number eight's Mike.
Tries to get around the corner, and they push him out at the eight. This is the eighth play of this drive.
That makes it second and goal.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Tate gained 6 yards with a short completion. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. It's up, and it is good.
And with that, all the pressure now shifts back to the other side. That's what a good kicker can do.
They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's a D4. That makes it 7-6.
It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on their own 29. Down at about the 37-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Three down. Mike four. Here we go.
Tackle at about the 45. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
That makes it second and 2.
Gets to about the 41-yard line. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
He gets to about the 31-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 31. Gains his way to the 19-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Three down. Mike four. Here we go.
Makes it to the 11.
That brings him second.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Just under three to go in regulation. Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Still be a little short of the first down line.
Well, they get some positive yards, but this defensive line really busted through and broke that play up.
We have 2 minutes left to play in this game. kicks away, and they tack on 3 points. And that gives them the lead.
I know that I call kickers head cases, but this kid isn't one. It's like he doesn't even feel the pressure.
Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, if you like defensive football, you got to love this one.
Now, neither one of these offenses have gotten really into a rhythm the entire ball game. Still the fourth quarter to be played. It's anybody's game.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain.
Excellent job by the defense to bring him down inbounds to keep that clock moving.
Makes the grab and out of bounds. From their own 37-yard line, first down. It out to his receiver in a hurry, and he tackles him hard at the 42-yard line. A little over a minute in the game. Going deep. Caught with room to work. Down the sideline. He gets hit out of bounds at the 14-yard line. After the big pass play, we've got a first down. Where in the world was he going on that run?
Well, that's a good question. I thought for a while he got his directions messed up.
Back and he's got space. Touchdown, and they take the lead. Looking to get 2 points here.
Let's go, let's go.
They'll need to hurry to get this off. Looks like they didn't get the playoff quick enough.
Delay of game, offense.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
So the offense is going to go for two. He scrambled. He's got the two. A nice 6-play, 76-yard drive, and they come away with 8 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. Fleming's mindset right now at this stage in the game has got to know that the defense is going to be attacking him.
Well, the defense is probably going to have two different defenders on him to stop him from making that big play for this offense. It's important that he and the quarterback are on the same page to be able to give them a chance to get some big yards and maybe eventually get them the winning score.
And he throws it away. From their own 25-yard line, second down. We have less than a minute to go. Got it to his man on the screen. That's a great tackle at the 24-yard line. Loss of a yard.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
And he's going to come up with a sack. The Longhorns are going to call their second timeout. This is their last chance. They need a big play here. He heaves it deep. And that just might do it. Intercepted. Oh, no. They really didn't need that.
And as a quarterback, you can't give up an interception late in the game. You got to be more careful with the football.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. The Longhorns using their third and last timeout. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. Impact on today's game, Kirk. We are expecting it to be on the positive side. Unfortunately for them, it ended up being a negative.
Yeah, definitely a tough loss to swallow. Typically, you'd like to see some other players step up and kind of help the cause when your great star player doesn't have an outstanding game. But in this case, I don't know if it would have made much of a difference.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.